Hi guys, this is Gopinath Krishnaraj. Welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, I'll share the Python programming level 2 values and variables. Please support me, like, share and comment it. This is needed for my improvements. In this video, to explore some building blocks that are used to develop Python programs. To experiment with the following concept: numeric values, strings, variables, assignment, identifiers and reserved words. Next we will discuss about integer and string values. The number 4 is an example of numeric value. In mathematics, 4 is an integer value. Integers are whole numbers, which means they have no fractional parts and they can be positive, negative or zero. Examples of integers include 4, minus 19, 0 and minus 1005. In contrast, 4.5 is not an integer since it's not a whole number. Python supports a number of numeric and non-numeric values. In particular, Python programs can use integer values like the statement print 4 prints the value 4. The value 4 is an example of integer expression. Python supports other type of expressions besides integer expressions. An expression is a basic building block of a Python statement. The number 4 by itself is not a complete Python statement and therefore cannot be a program. The interpreter, however, can evaluate a Python expression. The interactive shell attempts to evaluate both expressions and statements. In this case, the expression 4 evaluates to 4. The shell executes what is commonly called the read, evaluate, print loop. This means the interactive shell's sole activity consists of reading the text entered by the user, attempting to evaluate the user's input in the context of what the user has entered up that point, and printing its evaluation of the user's input. Here, Python uses the plus symbol, which integers, to perform normal arithmetic addition so the interactive shell can serve the result. The last line evaluated shows how we can use the plus symbol to add the values within the print statement that could be part of a Python program. This is an example. As you can see, the result of the expression 5 plus 10 is very different from the enclosed with a single quotation of 5 plus enclosed with a single quotation of 10. The plus operator splices two strings together in a process known as concatenation. In algebra, variables represent numbers. The same is true in Python, except Python variables also can represent values other than the numbers. Next, we will discuss about variables and assignment. This is an assignment statement. An assignment statement associates with the variable. The key to an assignment statement is the symbol equal, which known as assignment operator. The statement assigns the integer value 10 to the variable x. We may assign and reassign a variable as often as necessary. The type of variable will change if it is reassigned and expression of a different type. Here the example like print of x. This statement prints the variable x's current value. Note that the lack of quotation marks here is very important. If x has the value 10, the statement print of x, that means the prints the 10, the value of the variable x, but the statement not like print of single quotation with x. The prints x, the message contains a single letter of x. The meaning of the assignment operator is different from equality in mathematics. In mathematics, the equal symbol asserts that the expression on its left is equal to the expression on its right. In Python, equal symbol makes the variable on its left take on the value of the expression on its right. It is best to read x equal 5 as x is assigned the value 5 or x gets the value 5. This is distinction is important since the mathematics equality is symmetric. If x equal 5, we know 5 equal x. In Python programming, the symmetry does not exist. the statement 5 equal x attempts to reassign the value of the literal integer value 5, but this cannot be done because 5 is always 5, can't be changed. Here the next example, when the program runs, the print statement produces the different results. Here in assignment statement, x, y, z equal accordingly 100, comma minus 45 and 0. X, y, z is 1 triple and 100, minus 45, 0 is another triple. Triple assignment works as follows. The first variable in the triple on the left side of the assignment operator is assigned the value of the first expression in the triple on the left side, effectively x equal to 100. Similarly, the second variable in the triple on the left side of the assignment operator is assigned the value of the second expression in the triple of the left side, in effectively y equal minus 45. Z gets the value 0. Next, we will discuss about identifiers. While mathematicians are content with giving their variables one letter name like x, programmers should use longer, more descriptive variable names. Names such as sum, height and subtotal are much better than equally permissible, s, h and st. Variables name should be related to its purpose of within the program. A good variable names makes program more readable by humans. Since program often contain many variables, well-chosen variable names can render an otherwise obscure collection of symbols more understandable. Python has strict rules for variable name. A variable name is one of example and identifier. An identifier is a word to name things. One of the things an identifier can name is a variable. We will discuss about the identifiers such as functions, classes and methods. Identifiers have following form, which is an identifier must contain at least one character. The first character of an identifier must be an alphabetic letter, which means upper and lowercase or underscore. The remaining characters, if any, means may be alphabetic characters, upper, lowercase, and the underscore or digit, whatever it may be. No other characters, including spaces, are not be permitted in identifiers. A reserved word cannot be used as an identifier in our Python programming. Thank you guys. Thanks for watching this video. Please support me. Thank you guys.